Hey, what's going on, guys? Blake here from Pool Supply World, and I just wanted to take a second today to talk to you about heaters and heat pumps and basically look at those as two options, because I know that summer's coming to an end and pools are starting to close, which is a huge bummer. And so either a heater or a heat pump can be a good alternative to extend your swimming pool season if you want, but it's important to understand the differences and see which one is actually the best for you. So first, we'll take a look at heaters. So heaters use propane or natural gas. They burn propane or natural gas. And what happens is water's taken into the unit, and propane or natural gas is burning and heats up the water. Hot water goes back into the return lines to your swimming pool. Now the pros is it's less money up front as far as initial investment. It'll work in any temperature, any climate, which is awesome. And it'll heat the pool very quickly. And obviously, that's awesome. So the trade-off, though, is there's a little bit higher operating costs because you're paying for the propane or natural gas, and there's also more moving parts, and that's something to consider when you're buying, when you're making a large purchase, because the more moving parts there are, those are more potential things that could break. Now let's compare that to the heat pump. Now a heat pump actually uses electricity and ambient air to heat up the water. So the pros of this is that it's lower operating cost because you don't have to pay for propane. You do have to pay for electricity. It's environmentally friendly, which is nice. And it doesn't require a gas line, which is good because not every person has them. Now the cons is it's a little bit more money up front, and it'll only work above 50 degrees Fahrenheit because remember, it's using ambient air. So if it's super cold outside, it's just not going to be able to heat your pool water. So if you live in an area that gets down below 50 degrees Fahrenheit, you're not going to be able to use the heat pump at that time. So usually, even in those climates, I mean, you might be able to get a little bit more on either side of your swimming pool season. But as soon as it drops below 50 degrees, it's really not going to do anything for your pool. Now let's take a look at sizing. So for a heat pump, we're going to assume that we want to raise the temperature 1 degree per hour. And what we're going to do, the formula to figure out the recommended BTU is length times width of your pool times desired temperature raise times 12. So in our example, we take a pool that is 10 feet by 20 feet by 20 degrees raised times 12 equals 48K BTU. Now, compare that to a heater. They're sized a little bit differently. And just for simplicity, we're also going to assume that we're looking for a 1 degree per hour rise. Because when you use more BTU on a heater, it's actually just going to heat the pool faster. So if you have a 400K BTU heater and a 200K, the 400 will burn through the gas twice as quickly, but it'll heat the pool twice as fast. So it's really just up to you. But assuming 1 degree, just to make it simple, we take the gallons of the pool plus 10% times 10. So in our example, 30,000 gallon pool, 30K plus 3K times 10 equals 330K BTU. If you get more, it's gonna heat faster. And in either case, it is very important, critical even, that you use a solar cover, solar blanket, which is kind of looks like bubble wrap, goes on top of the pool when you're not using it, obviously. And that's because most of the heat loss that you're actually gonna get from your pool is gonna be due to evaporation. So if you can cover your pool with a solar cover, you're going to cut way back on the heat loss through evaporation, which is gonna make either a heat pump or a heater function properly and be more efficient. So those are two options. If you're like us and you don't wanna close your pool yet, you might wanna consider a heater or a heat pump. But it depends on where you live and what your budget is and really what you're looking to achieve. Have any questions? Comment right down below the video. You can email me directly, Blake@poolsupplyworld.com. Thanks for watching. That's it. I'm out.